Welcome again, guys. In this video tutorial, we are going to talk about Shine Dalgarno sequence. So what is Shine Dalgarno sequence? Shine Dalgarno sequence is a very conserved consensus sequence that is a ribosome binding site found in mRNA upstream of the translation initiation codon. Now, what does that mean? We have mRNA, and mRNA has the code for the production of proteins, because three nucleotide sequence structures that are found in mRNA acts like a codon for bringing a specific amino acid, and those amino acids will be joined to produce a protein. Now, for the production of protein, for the production of this protein process called translation, we need the machinery called ribosome, right? And ribosomes should recognize the initiation sequence that is present in mRNA to start the initiation of translation. And for the recognition of this initiation site for the ribosome, it requires the presence of a consensus conserved sequence called Shine Dalgarno sequence. Now look at here. Let's say this is the mRNA, or I should draw it little. Let's say this is the mRNA. Now let's say in this mRNA, we should have, it should be an open reading frame. An open reading frame means it should have a start codon, let's say AUG, this acting as a start codon. It should have a stop codon, let's say UGA, this is the stop codon, this is the start codon. So this is, and in between there are many different codons for coding the necessary protein, right? So everything is there in mRNA. tRNA will come and recognize all the sequence there and bring amino acid. But the machinery which helps in the synthesis or addition of all these things is called the ribosome. So ribosome, at the very beginning, let's say, let's draw the ribosome. This is the ribosome. Ribosome is present. Ribosome is mostly consisting of two things. One is rRNA and proteins, right? Ribonucleoproteins. So the rRNA that is present in the ribosome, let us draw it with a green color. Let's say this is the rRNA. Different rRNAs are there. So the rRNA in this subunit, let's say in this subunit is 16S rRNA. In the 16S rRNA, there are different sequences also present there. Now the idea is this ribosome should be attached with this mRNA, and it should attach itself with the start codon to initiate the translation or protein synthesis process, right? So how come this ribosome will sit to the mRNA for the initiation? They require a signal, right? So what will act as a signal for bringing this ribosome onto the right place of the mRNA to initiate the translation? That signal is brought by Shine Dalgarno sequence, which is found 8 base pair upstream of the start or initiation site. If this is the initiation site, AUG, 8 base pair before, there is a conserved sequence. If I zoom into this sequence, it will look like AGG, AGG. This is the conserved sequence. This sequence is known as Shine Dalgarno sequence, found in 8 base pair prior to the start site or initiation site of protein synthesis in mRNA. So ribosome will come, and let's say ribosome actually bring itself, and its ribosome is now on at the early stage, at the very a place where there is no start codon is there. Just ribosome is sitting. Ribosome will scan for this sequence, because in the 16S rRNA of that ribosome, it consists a complementary sequence of this Shine Dalgarno sequence. And that complementary sequence found in E. coli ribosome is ACC UCC UUA. This is in E. coli. This is the sequence ACC UCC UUA. So now remember, if it is ACC, again ACC UUA, sorry, ACC UCC UUA. So you can see it will have pairing here, 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 here. So it can pair with the Shine Dalgarno sequence if it finds the Shine Dalgarno sequence at the first place. For that, this ribosome scan through this mRNA from 5 prime to 3 prime direction for scanning this exact Shine Dalgarno sequence. Now, it might not contain the exact Shine Dalgarno consensus sequence in the organism. For example, in E. coli, it contains AGG, AGGU, this particular sequence in E. coli, AGG, AGGU. In some other organism, it might be something else, right? But it should have this consensus of conserved sequence nature, that is AGG, AGG, this repeat. Once it have that, ribosome, with the help of 16S rRNA, complementary nature of ACC, UCC, UUA, it can stall by pairing with the Shine Dalgarno sequence of mRNA. So imagine the situation now. Now this ribosome, once find this complementary sequence, it will bind itself there. And it will recognize that, yes, this is the time for starting the translation. Though it is 8 base pair before the start codon. So once it finds the Shine Dalgarno sequence, it provides a signal to the ribosome itself that, yes, now I get the signal. That means after 8 base pair now, we have the start or initiation point of translation. So it will bring all the machinery, it will turn on all the machinery and then bring all those tRNAs so that they can start the translation process as soon as they recognize the start AUG sequence, right? So that's how Shine Dalgarno sequence works in prokaryotes. This is an example for E. coli translation or protein synthesis, where the sequence for Shine Dalgarno is AGG, AGGU, and the 16S rRNA sequence is ACC, UCC, UUA, right? So that's it, guys. That's all about Shine Dalgarno sequence. If you like this video, please subscribe, hit the like button, share it with your social accounts, and I'll be very much happy to see that. And all the best. Thank you.